Hello everyone, one more time, I welcome you all in wonderful chemistry class, Learn Chemistry with Sharad Gupta. And my dear student, today's topic which we are going to take is comparison of molarity and molality. Yes student, today's topic is comparison of molarity and molality. Till now in our previous lessons, you have learned the definition of molality and its formula. Similarly, you have learned the formula of molarity, its formula and unit. Today we are going to do the comparison between the both. The first thing which we are taking today is molarity. If you see it carefully, student, it is R-I-T-Y, molarity. Molarity is having capital M as its symbol, number of moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Student, please see it carefully and please settle it in your mind that molarity, R-I-T-Y, goes with volume of solution in liter. The NB here is a mole of solute and V solution is a volume of solution and it has to be in liter. Emphasizing it one more time, student, because this is a sometime student make mistake here. The unit of solution must be in liter. If it is given in milliliter, we divide it by 1000 to make it in liter. It should come in liter here. Molality, M-O-L-A-L-I-T-Y, is number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 kg of solvent. Yes, student, please remember that here we are not talking about full solution. We are only talking about solvent. And here in place of volume, we are taking mass. In molality, mass is used and number of moles are divided by mass of solvent in kilogram. Here also, we are taking the unit of solvent in kilogram. If it is given in grams, we must convert it into kilogram by dividing 1000. This is NB is number of moles of solute and WA is the mass of solvent in kilogram. WA is mass of solvent in kilogram. To make us understand better, I will take one example by which we can calculate out molarity with the help of given data. As you can see in molarity formula, we need to know how many moles of solute are dissolved and we should also know how much is the volume of solution here. So let's say that 1 mole of KCl is dissolved in 1 liter of solution. That in this 1 mole of KCl dissolved in 1 liter of solution, 1 mole of KCl will be here NB and 1 liter of solution will be V solution. So NB, the mole of solute, is 1 mole and V solution, the volume of solution, is 1 liter here. So we write capital M molarity, R-I-T-Y molarity, is equal to number of moles of solute divided by V solution in liter. It comes out to be 1 mole divided by 1 liter. Hence it is equal to 1 mole per liter. It can also be mentioned as 1 m. This solution's concentration can also be mentioned as 1 m or 1 molar, M-O-L-A-R. Now coming back to the topic here, the comparison of molality and molarity here. Dear student, in your CBSE board exam, many times it is asked that what is the difference between molality and molarity and who is superior unit of expressing concentration. It is one of the favorite question in CBSE that molality and molarity, which one is a better unit for expressing concentration. Look at here, student. In molarity, since volume factor has come, volume changes with temperature. It means that one solution which is kept at one particular temperature, when it is transported to another temperature zone, then that temperature change will cause volume change, and because of the volume change, the molarity value of the solution will definitely change. While in case of molality, since both the factors are mass and mass remains free from any kind of temperature botheration, so whether it is in one temperature zone or in another temperature zone, the molality value remains the same. It is free from any type of temperature effect. So molality being a unit free from any kind of temperature effect is a preferred unit for expressing concentration in comparison to molarity. Same thing, student, I would like to clear you one more time here. Please see. Let's say that this is a bottle of chemical and it's written here 1 capital M. That means 1 mole of solute is present in 1 liter of solution. The name of country where it was packed was Russia, and the temperature there was minus 15 degrees centigrade. From there, this bottle is exported to our country, India, where the temperature is 35 degrees centigrade. So from minus 15 degrees centigrade, now the temperature change is to 35 degrees centigrade. The bottle which was having total volume of 1 liter and the number of moles was 1 mole here will be having more solution. Why the solution's volume will be more? Because almost this much increase in temperature causes expansion of volume. So volume of solution will be more, while the solute quantity which was 1 mole will remain the same. So it means that from where this bottle which started from Russia when reaches to India, it will be more diluted, and its molarity value, tell me student whether it will increase or decrease. Please see one more time. The volume has increased because of increase in temperature. The number of moles of solute remain the same. Since denominator is increasing, so the volume increase causes decrease in molarity. So molarity value will decrease here. While the same bottle, if it is having concentration in molality, since molality involves no variation, variable which depends on temperature, so molality value of this bottle will remain same whether it is coming from Russia to India or it is going from India to Russia, where two temperature zones are there. So in that way, molality value will remain same. So if it comes in CBSE that which type of unit of expressing concentration is better, then you can definitely answer molality is a better method for expressing concentration because it does not depend on temperature, its value remain the same. It here, student, we will take one example here for your understanding. These type of numericals are very common in CBSE and IIT exams, where we are provided solution of KI in water whose concentration is given 20% weight by weight. Density of solution is also given, and molecular mass of iodine as 127 and molecular mass of potassium as 39 gram per mole is given, and the examiner is asking the molality and mole fraction of KI and mole fraction of water. You can pause the screen now and try to solve this question. Take 5 minutes of time whether you can solve it correct or not, and match your answer with the solution which I am going to give you after a few moments. Yes, student, hope you have done this numerical problem and you can match your solution with this. The problem given to you was a KI solution in water is said to be 20% weight by weight. The density of the solution is given as 1.202 gram per milliliter. For this, we have to find molality, mole fraction and molarity. All the three values we have to find. So we are trying to find molality first. Please see here. In all such cases where density is given and percentage weight by weight is given, we start with this assuming solution to be 100 gram. Let's say solution is 100 gram, being 20% weight by weight, so we can easily say that the 20 gram is the solute here, and the remaining out of 100, if we subtract 20, the remaining 80 gram is the solvent. So for this, when we try to find out number of moles of the solute in this solution, that will come out to be 20, which is the mass in gram of solute, divided by molar mass of Ki, which is 127 plus 39, it comes out to be 0.1204 mole. So this is the mole of Ki, which is mentioned as NB here. When we calculate molality here, the mole of solute divided by mass of solvent in kilogram. Mole, we have calculated 0.1204 mole here. Mass of solvent, we assumed as 80 gram. So 80 gram means when we convert in kilogram, it comes out to be 80 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilogram. So when we solve this on simplification, we get the molality value as 1.505 mole per kg. So this is how molality can be calculated out. You can see one more time, we assume that solution is 100 gram. So the solute is 20 gram and the solvent is 80. We calculated moles of Ki, which comes out to be 0.1204. We calculated molality, where mole of solute is divided by mass of solvent in kilogram, which is 80 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilogram. So the answer is 1.505 mole per kg. Now coming for mole fraction. Mole fraction we can calculate for Ki first. So mole of Ki divided by mole of Ki plus mole of water. And here this is mole of Ki we have already calculated as 0.1204 divided by mole of water, which is 80 upon 18. So 4.44 will come here. 80 is the mass of water and 18 is the molar mass here. We assumed here our solution 100 grams, so mass of solvent comes out to be 80 gram. So 80 upon 18 will come out to be 4.44. This mole fraction on solving comes out to be 0.0264, and mole fraction of Ki will come this much, and mole fraction of water will come out to be 1 minus 0.0264, so which is equal to 0.9735. So mole fraction of Ki and mole fraction of water can be calculated out in this way. Hope your answer is correct. You are matching your answer with what I have done now. Molarity is a main thing here, to see that how we can calculate when volume is not given. But students, see that mass variable is given and density is given. When mass and density both are given, volume can be found out, because we know that density, mass and volume are related like this. So density is equal to mass upon volume. Volume is equal to mass upon density. Here we are finding volume of solution. So we take here mass of solution, which is 100 gram, divided by density. Mass is in 100 gram and density is in gram per milliliter. So there is no problem. Volume comes out to be 83.19 milliliter, and this can be converted into liter as 83.19 into 10 raised to minus 3 liter. The molarity formula is mole of solute NB divided by volume of solution in liter, so which is 0.1204 mole divided by 83.19 into 10 raised to minus 3, and the answer is 1.447 mole per liter. Hope student you got this solution of this particular numerical, and all the answers were correct. And with this I finish today's class. Wish you all the very best. Have a happy learning. You are watching Chemistry with Sharad Gupta class. Please press bell button and subscribe my channel for further information. Thank you very much. God bless you all.